So you're on Insta. If I see you, I'll connect you quickly. Hi, Darwin.
Okay. Wait one second. I cannot see you yet. Can you, is it on live yet?
Yeah, we are on Facebook Live. We'll start talking. I can't see you in Insta though.
Yeah, so I'm trying to find you on Insta as well. Yeah, it's come now. I'm on your live.
Okay, then I'll see you and I'll quickly add you then.
Yeah.
Yep.
I'll send you a request. I'm
Hello.
sending it. Okay.
Saying hi to us. Lovely. Hi,
Hey.
Dr. Kaur, how are you?
Hello, Aarti. Thank you for having me.
Lovely. So, we are going to talk about the topic of building immunity with dental health in period of lockdown. It's a very, very interesting topic, and I'm super excited about the same. How about you?
Me too, Aarti. I was looking forward to this for quite some time, so let's see how it goes.
Lovely. So
How it goes?
I want to thank you. Actually, I'll stop the Insta because the echoing is happening. So we'll just continue on Facebook.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. So I want to thank you, Darwin, for coming on our platform and spending time to give knowledge about dental hygiene and also how it impacts our immunity.
Thank you, Aarti.
And before we go ahead and start the session, I would like our audiences to know that I'm Aarti Pandey from Folk Fitness, and our mission is to have freedom from PCOS. But at the time of immunity, we are ensuring that we give a lot of tips on the five pillars, which is eat right, move correctly and all the time, sleep well, breathe with awareness and happiness quotient. And you, Dr. Tarveen, would help us to know how can dental hygiene help us in the immunity. We have Anand, Dheeraj, Saket, Priya, Vinita all saying hi to you.
Hello, hello, hello everyone.
So
I'm just trying. Yeah. Go ahead,
I'll
Aarti.
just introduce you to our audience today. Dr. Tarveen Kaur, a well-known name and face in the field of dentistry. She did her dentistry from Pune and her doctorate from Boston University. Wow. After practicing in the US for 5 years, she relocated to Pune in 2007 and has been running her own dental practice by the name New Age Dental Care. Her practice was ranked second and third in Pune by the Times Health Survey in 2017 and 2019 also. Her practice was nominated as the best aesthetic practice by Famdent in Maharashtra in 2018. She's very well known for her dental awareness workshops in reputed schools of Pune and online on her social media to promote good dental hygiene and reduce dental anxiety. She is one of the few in Pune who's trained in digital smile designing as her passion is to make healthy, beautiful smiles. That's interesting. Her other passion is to improve the awareness of overall oral health and remove the fear of dentists in people. And that's amazing. Thank you so much, Tarveen. That's some introduction. Wow. And I must
Thank
tell
you.
you that I know you through the great gym buddy that you are of me and how great you are in taking care of your own health also.
You know, if I really miss something in this lockdown, Aarti, is your you're one of my motive. You know how you motivate me in the gym, the way you work out in that beast mode. I mean, really, I'm working out at home even now, but watching you is one of the things I really miss. So I do log on to your classes, in fact, of your Folk Fitness, and it's amazing the way you guys are, you know, spreading positivity and making people happy with their dances. It's really fun. So I do go on once or twice a week to, you know, just shake off that stress and dance with you all.
I'm so happy to hear that. And it's a privilege to have you watch our sessions. We do it on every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday at 6 o'clock. And it's absolutely complimentary for all our people.
Lovely.
Buddy Abhishek Malpani saying hi to us.
Hi, Abhishek.
Tanvesh is here, Mukta is here. So we have quite an audience. So for all of you guys, any question that you have for Dr. Tarveen Kaur, please type it down and I shall pick it up. For now, Tarveen, the question that I have for you is, in this unfortunate period of COVID-19, we all are trying to improve our immunity to fight this deadly virus. Could you tell us how immunity is related to dental health?
Okay, so, you know, this is something that you really have to ponder about. It's very interesting. So remember that oral health is actually a window to your overall health. So I'm going to explain how that works. Our mouth has a wet environment and we all know there is bacteria, right, Aarti? There is bacteria in everyone's mouth. So they are good and bad bacteria. The moment you don't brush your teeth or you don't floss and you don't take care of your dental hygiene or you have leftover food particles left in your mouth, so that moist environment that we have in our mouth is ideal for the bacteria to grow. And that's the reason why people start getting dental cavities and gum problems. So people will think it's all in the mouth. So why am I worried about how it's going to affect my overall health and immunity, right? So we have gums which have, there is blood. So your infections from your mouth can actually enter your bloodstream through your mouth and enter your body. That's how they actually start reducing your immunity. So there's a whole science behind it. I'm not going to get into the details of how to do it. So once your immunity is reduced, it actually makes the person susceptible to conditions like diabetes, like, cardiovascular diseases, that's your heart problems. So it doesn't directly cause it, but it does reduce your immunity. So you become more susceptible. And you know, coronavirus loves individuals with have low immunity. So your diabetes and hypertension, all these things are going to make you even more worse. So your reaction to coronavirus is going to be even more adverse. So it's not actually the coronavirus that is killing people. You know that, right? It's our immunity, which is, you know, failing us. And we can't defend this particular virus, which has come in the pandemic. So that's how our dental hygiene has become even more important nowadays.
You said such a valid point, Tarveen, that it is not the virus that's killing us. It's our immunity. And that's Fitness, we've taken this up to how do we build a super immunity? What are the steps? What a person should do at lockdown? And we always keep saying you have two options: either just sit around and watch Netflix and Amazon,
or
you can just get up and make sure that every part of your body is active. And like you just correctly said, I feel people just take teeth
for granted.
All right, it's a habit to brush, so. We just brush. We actually would like to come to the topic as to how to brush correctly. And I have come to you. I have learned. I will accept that I was also making some mistakes. Yes, I do make mistakes. I hate to admit it sometimes. Before I ask my second question, Tarveen, we have Harpreet here. Can you say hi to Harpreet? She's very, very...
Hello, Harpreet.
And she's asking, hello, Doc. How should we floss? And does flossing cause space in the teeth? That's another question that a lot of people have.
So that's a myth that I actually try and clarify as much as I can in my dental practice and whomever I talk to. So yes, you must 100% floss. There is no two way about it. And you cannot replace it with brushing, with vigorous rinsing, with anything that you do. And especially a toothpick. Please do not touch that toothpick. So the floss, basically the science behind floss is, I'm actually going to just, I've kept a floss ready here. So I just want to explain what is the reason behind why the floss will not cause. So you see, it's really thin. Is it possible for you to see?
Absolutely.
So between our teeth, we actually have a natural gap. Every tooth has a natural gap. That natural gap, keeping that in mind, the floss is made even thinner than that natural gap. So if you're going to put this floss in between the teeth, it's going to go in that natural gap very easily. It may be a little obstructive at one point where it contacts, which I'll explain later because I don't want to get into it now. But this floss is so thin and it's really a thread Do you really think we can create gaps and move those hard teeth which are stuck in bone with just a piece of thread? Then we won't need braces, right? We would just be removing teeth with flosses all around, right? So, to answer that question, floss is definitely not a disadvantage. It is definitely an advantage to use every day.
So you will recommend floss for everyone to use?
100%, everyone, even children.
Okay, and is there an age for children to start using?
So, when you you start getting like the children when they get their permanent teeth, you know, when their permanent teeth are out and they start building contacts between their teeth, that's when they start using the floss. Plus, they're a little older to know how to handle it, and they'll be able to use it because you don't want them injuring their gums in the bargain as well.
And you teach how to floss because there's
Yes.
very sure
Yes. So we're going to get into that for sure. That's definitely upcoming.
audiences, hold on. If you don't have a floss right now with you, go in your washrooms, carry them because Tarveen here will show us how we do flossing correctly. She's saying thank you to you.
Superb.
Okay, we have one more question from Mukza. Hi,
Okay.
Mukza. I hope you're working out regularly. She's another person who's very, very regular in our group.
Lovely.
Teeth problem, however, in this lockdown, unfortunately, she's got severe toothache since more than a week now.
Okay.
These are not open now, so want to ask how many painkillers or antibiotics a day? Please advise as I'm having sleepless nights. So
Okay. Okay. Yeah, so my first worry over there is you trying to take medications on your own. So over-the-top medications are available, the pharmacies are open, but please do not misuse it. Antibiotic is a total no until a doctor has personally prescribed it to you, because if your body gets used to those frequent antibiotics that we keep taking, you don't want your body to build that resistance, because then later on in life, if you ever need, you'll have to take much higher doses of antibiotics to deal with it. So please, please do not take any antibiotics. I would even say a painkiller. It's always best to consult your dentist. So this is my solution to this right now, since we are on a lockdown and dental clinics are closed. Dentists are available online. A lot of us dentists in our dental community have gone on video consultations, and we're doing it for free because we really care for our patients. We are as worried as you are because our clinics are closed, but we are there for you. We have not closed our communication. So please do call up your dentist if you have one. If you don't, I am also available. I have a website called newagedental.in. If you go on that, there is a instant link of online dental consultation. You could book your slot on my calendar, and I would be happy to help you. So unless and until I don't see the reason of the dental pain, it's tough for me to just give a remedy right now. But you know, a consultation, it's really free. Just come online and let me see what the problem is, and I could prescribe you what would help you.
that's amazing. So Mugda, here you go. You just wrote that your dentist brother is there, but you have a lot of pain. So you have New Age Dental Clinic right there. Just go and book your slot with Dr. Tarveen, and she would be able to help you and then suggest whether you should take painkillers or antibiotics, or you just have some home remedy from her that will help.
Yes.
Great, doc. Thank you. There's a very interesting question, and I personally also want to know this. This is from Anjana Rajan. Hi, Anjana. So
Hi,
she,
Anjana.
how can we make a homemade mount rinse?
Oh,
That's it.
really? Interesting. Very interesting. Okay, so yes, mouth rinses, there are many available in the market. Everyone knows the Colgate plaques. We have Listerine, we have chlorhexidine, we have Rexidine. But yes, you don't have, since we cannot keep going and buying and purchasing things right now and you're at home, there are two ways actually. So I'm sure everybody has baking soda in the kitchen, right? But Aarti, you must be having it too. So baking soda, take 2 teaspoons of baking soda in a cup of warm water. Just mix it. You can use it as a mouth rinse. You swish it, use it for about 30 seconds at least in your mouth before you actually throw it out. That will really help you as a mouth rinse. Secondly, if you have apple cider or white vinegar, I'm sure many have that, it's easily available. You can put that in water, just about 2 tablespoons in a whole glass of water. You can even use that as a mouth rinse. same thing, use it for 30 seconds in your mouth and spit it out.
Awesome. So baking soda in warm water?
Yes.
Or apple cider?
Apple cider or white vinegar.
Okay, great. So Anjana, please try that and write down how did you feel after using this homemade mouth rinse. So that's great. We have two more questions coming up. Actually, sure. They both Grace. Hi, Grace.
Hello.
So before I take this question, I request all the audience, all the 50 of you who are there right now, please show a thumbs up if you are actually getting some insights from this session and if you're enjoying this conversation. Please show us some thumbs up, some clap for Dr. Tarveen so we understand. You have a Priya Bhatija saying hi, Veenu.
So hi, Priya. She's my very good friend from Bombay. Hi, Priya.
So guys, okay. So Grace is asking, okay, a lot of thumbs up, the questions going on. What are the best ways to practice good oral hygiene at home?
Okay.
Second question is how to prevent tooth decay.
Okay.
So best practices that she can do at home, oral hygiene at home.
Okay, so Aarti, if you want to address this question, we could go into the dental hygiene tips at home.
The right time. Do you want the audience to carry something or just listen or
if I don't think so. I think they can just watch. So we can just go ahead with that.
Our doc today is going to actually show you some of the basic oral hygiene things that you can do in your washroom and also tell you how we are doing so many errors. So here you are.
Okay. So I'm going to get a little help from my son because I needed a model and he happily agreed to come online. So I'm going to bring him over and I'm going to demonstrate. So I have things which are lying new here. So I'm using a new toothbrush for him so I could actually demonstrate it well. Arya, can I have you here, please?
In the meanwhile, can I request everyone to just hold on to your questions because they are moving. I see a lot of questions. So once this, she has demonstrated this, if I've missed out any question, please retype it so that I can pick it up. Hi.
Can you see us clearly? So that's Arya. You want to say hello?
Hi.
Hi. Thank you for coming online and helping us to demonstrate it to the audience. Thank you so much.
Okay. So basically, the first thing to start with is you have to brush 2 times a day. I mean, there is no shortcut. And believe me, you don't have the excuse right now. What's the excuse now, Aarti? The best excuse?
We can't say we don't have time. We have slept. We've come late.
Yeah, I'm too busy. I'm too tired. You know, I just want to go to sleep. I have to run. I have to go to school. You know, all those excuses are done. So please, let's not go there. So the reason, I'll tell you, there are 2 things. This is very interesting. Brushing in the night is even more important than brushing in the morning. Do you know why, Aarti?
I do.
Yeah, because I told you. So we brush in the night because we've eaten all day and, you know, you've had your snacks, you've had your dinner, you've had multiple things. We use our teeth the entire day. So imagine the kind of food particles and things that are collected in between your teeth after that entire day. And if you go to bed with that, is as good as me going and playing, you know, like kids playing in the big playground and they're going to have all that mud on their hands. Will they be able to sleep? No. So you definitely want to wash your hands. You want to wash your face. You want to sleep clean. So why not wash your teeth? Aren't they dirty? Interesting to think about it. So when we are sleeping, our mouth is actually closed for like 6, 8, 9, I don't know how many hours everybody sleeps, but our mouth is closed and all that bacteria, which is in our mouth, is having a feast at night because you've left so much food in your mouth and so much of plaque for them. So when the mouth is closed and the mouth is dry, all those food particles are stuck inside. The germs will actually sit and attack. So that's my answer to the question, how dental decay is formed. That's exactly how it happens. The bacteria attacks, it releases acids, it starts creating big holes in your teeth. That's called the cavity. You know, Aarti, actually many people don't know what's a cavity. So I'm going to just say that. It's a hole in your tooth. Yeah, I sometimes get that. They're just like, cavity, yeah. So
it sounds so scary.
So that's what, so if you brush at night, believe me, I can tell you more than half your dental problems are sorted like that. Okay. So don't have any excuse. Do brush at night. In fact, pay more attention, use more time, more technique in the night. Morning brushing, you're already sleeping with a clean mouth. But I'm telling you, if you get up and you open your mouth in front of your family members, they're going to faint. So please do brush your teeth to get that odor out of your mouth. So that's the reason why we brush in the morning. So to brush, basically, you need a medium-sized brush. For children, you can use the smaller heads. For adults, there are normal standard sizes available. You have a medium, soft, and hard bristles. The soft ones are for sensitive teeth, usually a little for older patients who have very sensitive teeth, so they can use soft. Adults, normally, they can you go with the medium. Don't go for the soft because the soft will not, it'll be too soft for your teeth and you won't be able to clean them really well. So go for a medium toothbrush is the best. There are hard brushes available as well. I'm not particularly fond of them because I feel people tend to misuse those and they tend to wear down their teeth more than them actually doing it. So I honestly don't know why those hard toothbrushes are being sold. I'm totally against it. So personally, according to me, don't buy them. So buy the medium toothbrush, toothpaste, whichever you use, believe me, they all do the same job. So don't think Colgate or Close Up or, Vico Vajradanti or
तो ऐसा नहीं है कि किसी में नमक ज्यादा है और किसी में कम।
नहीं, they all do the entirely same. So what toothpaste do you use, Aarti?
आई यूज क्लोज अप रेड।
Very good. So whatever taste, whatever flavor, whatever. So basically they're available in different flavors because you tend to get bored of using the same toothpaste. So you just change and just feel better. So use any that you like and that you personally feel is good, but make sure it is fluoridated. So fluoridated toothpaste is very important for you. Use that, and the technique of brushing is more important than using a lot of pressure. So don't use a lot of force. You're going to use enough just finger pressure on your teeth because the harder you brush, the more you scrub them over the years, you tend to wear them down. Did you know that, Aarti?
Yeah, I have
Of course, I know at all.
a good dentist friend, so.
So we're going to take the toothbrush and we're going to start from the back of your teeth. So please make sure you go to the entire back. So I'm going to take it there. Close your teeth. He's going to close his teeth. He's going to turn sideways. I'm going to use it outside so you can see how I'm holding the toothbrush. It's going to be in an angle. So you're going to go up and down, round and round. A lot of people like to do back and forth. This is the ideal way of people how they brush. Well, I think, people wash clothes like that with brush. So please don't do back and forth too much because the more you do this, you go against the curvatures of your teeth and you tend to flatten them over time. That's the reason why we tell you all to go up and down because you'll go in between the teeth, how much ever you can. Also, you will go along the curvatures of your teeth. They're not flat, they're all rounded.
Didn't we have that song as a child? Up and
Bru
down.
brush, brush, brush your teeth every single day. No, I'm not going to sing for you, Aarti. No. For the front, okay, so we start with the back. You're going to keep going all the way around till the time you go to the top. So you're going to go outer surface of your teeth. Once you're done, open your mouth big. You're going to clean the back of your teeth, okay? So the back of your teeth, if you're going to clean them horizontal this way or try to do this way, it is actually wrong. So come a little bit in the front area. We're going to use it vertical for the lower teeth. So you're going to go up and down, up and down, up and down, very gently for the lower. Turn the toothbrush and go up and down, up and down, up and down for the top. So you're going to do that for the front. Don't forget to clean the tops of your teeth on the back, the lower teeth, and the top teeth. So there are three surfaces that you're going to clean of your teeth: the outer surface, the inner surface, and the tops of the teeth. And how much time it takes, Aarti? That's your test.
What?
How much time do you take to brush your teeth?
I take 10 minutes.
Ah, 10 minutes. No way, you're lying. How
Oh,
much time?
I really take 10 minutes since the time since the time I enter the washroom, I apply the toothpaste.
Okay, let's not be unrealistic. I'm sure nobody's going to spend 10 minutes on their teeth. So Arya is going to point the fingers of how many minutes CV should be brushing.
2 minutes.
2 minutes. So let's not overbrush our teeth because we don't want to wear them down. 2 minutes is also good enough. So please do brush 2 minutes a day, morning and night.
That's it. So all it takes is 2 minutes, morning at night, for the dental hygiene, and she has shown us how beautifully we had to do, and we don't have to really use it the way we wash our
Yeah.
clothes.
So there is one more thing you're going to clean in your mouth, and what is that? Other than your teeth?
The gums?
No.
What is
So
it?
Arya is going to say it.
Tongue.
Ah, tongue.
Very important. So, do you know the reason for bad breath? One of the major reasons is because people forget that tongue is there. So, our tongue has papillae, it's a rough surface. We tend to trap food particles, pigments from food, odor containing food particles in those papillae because it's rough. So, you'll see after you eat a candy, doesn't it change your color of your tongue, Aarti? Pink, blue, if you eat candies. I don't know. I'm sure you don't eat candies.
But I know people
Yeah.
who their color changes.
So you have to clean your tongue after you finish brushing. You could use your bristles of the toothbrush to clean your tongue, or you could use the back. There are some toothbrushes which have the rough surface to clean your tongue, or you could use the tongue cleaner, the scraper that they call it, after you're done brushing. So make sure you brush your tongue because that's one of the top more reasons for bad breath, even after you brush.
Awesome. So you have a lot of people answering. They have Dina and Nikhil have said tongue. So good job. They've answered the question, Arya. They are also as intelligent as you are. Has answered 2 minutes. So the question was for the audience, how much time should you brush? So all you need is 2 minutes. And Tarvin, you said all three are good enough, or you recommend tongue cleaner, or you recommend doing it with the
No,
brush?
any of them. They all do the same job. So whatever you prefer, whatever is your liking, please go ahead and do it. Would you want me to show how to floss?
Okay, if the audience says yes. So, audience, do you want doctor to show us how to floss? Then I want to see some thumbs up, some yeses, something quickly. If I see more than 10, then we are going ahead with it. Till those thumbs ups come, Tarveen, there's a question for you here, which is
Let me finish the question. Yeah. Okay.
Priya. She's asking, she drinks turmeric water every morning. Will
Okay.
that stain her teeth?
Will that?
Stain her teeth. Would she have stains?
Yes. So turmeric water definitely will cause yellowish tinge on your teeth. So I would not advise her to do it every day.
Okay. So, turmeric, do you have any more things which definitely stain? Smoking, I heard.
Smoking, yes. Wine, red wine, coffee, tea. Yeah, these are one of the topper ones.
Solution whenever you have it, is there a
So what you
solution?
can do is, yeah, so a lot of people who have a lot of tea, coffee, when we are at work, we are stressed, we keep drinking a lot of coffee back to back. And at least the patients that have come to my clinic have always complained that, their teeth get stained so fast. So I always advise them. I know sometimes it's not that easy, but it's just a matter of habit. You could rinse your mouth after the tea or coffee. That would at least remove the residual tea coffee left in your mouth because that's what's causing the stain.
Okay. Awesome. And we've got a lot of yeses and a lot of thumbs up for the floss question. And
Super.
Dina has 3 questions. Sure, Dina, shoot those 3 questions and we'll pick them up. We have another 10 minutes to go. So, yes, mouthwash is essential. You can go ahead with the
So, okay, so I'm going to show the floss quickly. Come. So, when you're doing a floss, you need to take, there are a lot of flosses available. So, I've actually kept one here. There is one in Colgate. And you have Oral-B. Try and take a waxed dental floss because those have got a wax layer on them. So, it's easier to slip them between your teeth. So, you need to take a particular length. So, they should be about that long. Okay. And you're going to, use this long piece because you need it to anchor your floss between the first two fingers. So your index fingers, you're going to actually anchor the floss between your first two fingers, and you're going to use your thumb to push it in between the two teeth. Like I told you, the two teeth are meeting at a contact point. So when you're trying to put the floss, you're going to reach some resistance in between the two teeth. So don't let that stop you. Go a little bit more in that resistance, and it'll suddenly snap in into a space which is the place which is just above the gum. So you can go back and forth, clean it, and move it out. So My son obviously has milk teeth and permanent teeth right now, so his contacts might be a little loose. So it'll be easier for me to actually put the floss through. But in permanent teeth, for us adults, it's a little tougher. But once you get the hang of it, you'll exactly know how much pressure to put. So you're going to use this too, and you're going to come closer, 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 closer. Open big. You're going to push it. Ah, look here. Okay. You're going to push it. I don't know whether you can see it. So I'll do the front tooth. You're going to push it in between the two teeth. Go up. Go back and forth and just snap it out. Go
Okay.
in between the two teeth, back and forth, snap it out. So when you snap it out, you will see food particles, plaque, everything stuck on this. So you can actually switch and go to another section. That's the reason why we took such a long piece. So you can change and use the cleaner part of that floss. So once you start flossing, you actually understand where the food is collecting more. And when you tend to start removing that, you'll see that you'll get habituated and you'll want to do it every day. And believe me, the cavities in between the teeth only are because people are not flossing. So if you start doing that in this lockdown, please start doing it. Watch yourself in the mirror initially. I'm sure there are YouTube videos which might be a little easier for you to understand rather than me showing here. But go watch it. Watch yourself in the mirror. It will take a little time in the beginning. But believe me, by the time you're done with it, it takes me at least 15 seconds and I'm done with all teeth. Now, not just because I'm a dentist, but I just do it very regularly. So that's the thing. Thanks, Arya.
Welcome. Thank you so much, Arya. Thank you so much, Doc. And there are a lot of questions, so I'll pick them up quickly. But
Yes.
with floss, there is a question that no one has asked, but I think you must tell them that it's all right to have a little bleeding whenever you're flossing, or is it not normal?
So when it bleeds, there are two reasons. It could bleed because you've gone very harsh with your floss. It's possible because when we are initially trying to do, we may injure ourselves. So don't go very hard through that contact. Just go very gently. Secondly, if our gums are already a little inflamed, the first thing they'll do is bleed. So when you're putting a floss in between the teeth, your gums will bleed. That could be an indication that your gums are a little inflamed. That's because your oral hygiene has, not been really good and your gums are a little swollen. So when your gums heal back, you can start flossing and the bleeding will stop. So it could be normal or it could indicate that there could be some swelling there.
Okay, thank you. Dina has three questions and I find them pretty interesting. The
Okay.
first, how to fight teeth sensitivity.
Okay.
Second is neem datoon recommended?
Okay.
Is it a myth that eating too much of sweet food leads to more chances of teeth decay? Dina, you
Okay.
want but then talk.
So the first one, sensitive teeth. When you have sensitive teeth, it's very important for us to understand why do you have that sensitive teeth. Is it because your teeth have worn down? Is it because generally some people have thin enamel by birth? It's hereditary. So if they have thin enamel, they tend to be sensitive to cold, even ice creams or cold water, and they're not able to bear it, which is normal for them. You could do anti-sensitive toothpaste, the Sensodyne, the Thermoseal, the Colgate sensitive, and they do work. So you could switch from your normal toothpaste to the sensitive toothpaste. Use it regularly like a regular toothpaste. It takes 2 or 3 weeks for the effect to actually show up. It's not miracle. It's not going to happen overnight. Use it regularly and you will definitely see an effect. In fact, a good pointer, just apply the toothpaste around the areas where you're really sensitive. Keep it for about 10, 15 seconds and then brush over it. I'm sure it'll help you.
Great. So I hope Dina that answered your first question. And then is neem datoon recommended?
I'm not very good promoter of these things at home. Yes, old age people have done it. It cannot cause you harm. If no benefit, no harm. If you want to do it, it's fine.
And is it a myth that eating too much of sweet food leads?
So eating too much at one time is not going to cause you cavity. Understand this, it's the amount of times that you're having it in the day. So if you are having it 4 or 5 times a day, you're actually putting your teeth under sugar attack 4 or 5 times a day. But if you're eating sweet once a day, even if you eat like 10 chocolates at one time, it's going to affect that once only. So I hope I answered my question. Limit the number of times you put your teeth under attack, and that will help you. Don't stop sweets. I eat chocolates too every day. Don't tell anyone, Arti.
Ah. asked one question twice, and I would like to pick that up. How to maintain filling in lockdown?
How to maintain?
Chipping.
Chipping or filling?
Chipping.
Chipping. So if you have old fillings which are actually were wearing off, and you know, some the dentist must have told you to replace it and you didn't do it and this lockdown happened. So I would suggest just don't have anything very hard on those fillings. That's the only thing you can do. There is no protective shield or any cover that you can put right now, unfortunately. So wait for the lockdown to get over. And if things are weak, we are going to be opening the clinics and we are going to be taking all care and dental treatments will start. So don't panic now. Just avoid really hard. Don't break, you know, open things or make do things with your teeth adventurous when you know those are weak teeth.
Okay. Pooja Goswami is asking, what do you do if a filling has come off?
Pooja, hi. She's a very good friend of mine from Bombay. So if the filling has come off and if there's a hole, best is you'll have to rinse your mouth with salt water. So warm salt water, guys, is really good. It's anti-inflammatory. It's antiseptic. So any kind of food particles, you know, sticking into those areas where the filling is broken, remove those food particles. Because that's what's going to cause the pain. So don't use toothpicks. I had people who told me, who called me up and they said, we've been putting toothpicks. So what happens is you injure your gum and that area even more and the pain. So it's a vicious cycle. So don't do that. Make sure there's no food collecting there. Do salt water rinses and just wait for the lockdown to get over and replace your filling.
So that's a very interesting thing that you're saying, wait for the lockdown. So Tarveen, could you tell our audience what are the things they must wait? What are the emergencies and what are something that they can wait till the lockdown? Because I'm sure if the chipping happens or a filling comes out, you panic.
Yeah, so, it does. So I have been getting panic calls because I'm doing online consultations as well. So I did open the clinic once or twice for a real emergency. That was a patient of mine who had broken her front tooth. And she really broke it. And so I had to help her out because there was no way she could have carried on this lockdown with that. So an emergency would be a dental trauma or an accident, you know, some way that maybe a child has fallen or you have banged or something has happened to your tooth and you've broken it. Please do contact us or contact your dentist. Swellings, any real severe pain, sleepless nights, you need a root canal. You know, those kind of things are emergency right now. Or if you are having braces in your mouth and the wire has come off or the clip has broken, yes, it's an emergency. Do contact your dentist and they will take care of it. Things that can be put for later now is about, obviously, your regular teeth cleaning. Please do defer that now for a few months till we are out of this pandemic. You know, your old fillings changing or teeth bleaching. Any cosmetic work, these kind of things will pick up later on. Our dental clinics, when we open, we are going to be seeing patients much lesser in a day because we have a lot of protocol which has been put by IDA, you know, the American Dental Association. We have a lot of things going on. There's a whole thing we have to follow. So we need to do all those protocols for every patient because we want to make sure the environment is safe for our patients. And all, believe me, all the dentists are working as a community together. We all are taking care. We want to give you a safe environment for yourselves and for us, of course. So we will be seeing lesser patients a day. So please be mindful that there will be longer appointments because we want to finish a lot of work at one appointment. And if you have appointments, do show up and don't miss them because, you know, it's going to be a challenge now. So there are a couple of things, you know, we are going to be doing in the clinics, but it will be safe to go. So don't be scared. Don't be anxious. That's what I want to say. And just be mindful when you go to a dental practice, make sure it's to that standard that you are getting that safe environment.
Awesome. Before we wrap up, we're going to take 2-3 more questions. Rajhu Hira says very informative tips. Thank you so much. That's what she's here to give, a lot of tips and a lot of home remedies. So we will pick up 3 more questions, so quickly write them down so that I can pick them up. And while you're typing, please know
Aarti,
that tomorrow...
before we address the questions, because we're ending, I actually wanted to talk about the toothbrushes, which is, I think, very important for people. So do we finish that up?
Absolutely.
Okay, so toothbrushes, everybody at home, we really take it for granted. They're just lying in our bathrooms and, we tend to brush. So I'm going to give a little few pointers of toothbrush, which I feel is very, very important in this pandemic because the germs from our mouth are going on these bristles, on these toothbrushes. Make sure they're clean because you don't want getting cold and fever and even the regular flu now, which happens a lot because we're taking this for granted. So when you're storing your toothbrushes, the first thing is, wash your hands before and after the use of toothbrushes because we're again dealing with germs. And I think we all have done PhDs in washing hands, right? So do wash your hands. Use your toothbrush. Before you use, make sure you nicely wash because dust collects on these toothbrushes. You don't want them putting them in your mouth with the dust. Rigorously, nicely clean them up. Toothpaste, when you're putting, keep it away from the tip. So do not touch the tip of the toothpaste because your whole family is using that tube. Once you're done using it, wash it very well. Shake off all the excess water so it's not wet fully. When you store it, make sure it air dries. If you have these plastic caps, do not immediately put them on once they're wet because the wet environment in these are also going to help the bacteria to grow. So please let them air dry, then put these covers on if you like to. If you're storing multiple toothbrushes in the bathroom with your family members, please make sure the bristles are not facing each other and they're touching because you can really imagine now what's happening here. We have residual germs here and here from other person's mouth. So please avoid this.
Virus like the humans are these days.
Yes. So social distancing of toothbrushes is very important. So please keep them at a distance. Even if they're a husband and wife, we need social distancing in the toothbrush.
Like, I'm gonna remember this. I'm sure all of them are going to remember this.
So, how about keeping them this way? I think that would be safe enough, and I think that's enough distance. And just keep them at a distance from your toilet as well. Very important because the germs are there. You don't want these toothbrushes lying over that. Okay. So, when you want to disinfect, please disinfect your toothbrushes because we use them for 2 to 3 months. One way to disinfect is put sodium, the baking soda in water and soak these bristles inside that baking soda for 10 minutes once a week. And you're going to wash these handles with soap and water once a week for sure. So the same day you do the soaking, please wash this with soap and water. So these brushes are germ-free as much as you can keep them. If you've been sick, please discard your toothbrush once you're well because you don't want to be using the same toothbrush pack again. So change your toothbrush after you've got well. And you can change your toothbrush every 3 months.
Okay, that was very, very informative. I want to see some thumbs up. How many of you are going to follow this? Brushing twice in a day, 2 minutes.
Yes, 2 minutes, not 10 minutes, Aarti.
10 minutes, 2 minutes. You know, I was joking. I
I
wanted
know.
Arya to feel that he can answer. Twice in a day, flossing, not too hard. And up and down, round and round. See, Tarveen, I'm a good student.
Very good.
Keep social distancing with the family toothbrushes and make sure to disinfect it with baking soda and wash the handles. Show me some thumbs up if you've heard it and if you're going to apply this. Also, Tarveen, tomorrow we come live at 6 o'clock and it's a cultural special, cultural
Okay.
day. People who are from Punjab, who are from Haryana, who are from Maharashtra are going to do some little thing of
Oh,
their
wow.
culture. It could be a bindi, a nug. They could wear. So please join us tomorrow at 6 p.m.
Interesting.
for some focus
Lovely.
session. We are not yet done because Arpan is asking, and she's asked twice, so I have to take. I like the way she's consistently asking.
Hi, Arpan.
Should
She's my
be.
Bhabhi.
Oh, okay. So she. Consulting, am I? Yes, so they are
No,
made.
she lives in Delhi, so I wish I at this time I would have been in Delhi if the lockdown was not there.
Should we floss after every meal, or too much flossing is not good?
No, there's nothing like too much flossing. As much flossing as you can do, it's fantastic for your teeth. So please floss after every meal or after everything you eat or anytime you feel there's food impacted, floss.
Lovely. Even brushing, if after meal in the afternoon we brush, is it?
No, I feel brushing should be because brushing can cause flattening of teeth. Don't do overzealous too much of brushing. Brushing can, you can do rinsing after meals, that's good. Brushing twice, maximum 3 times a day is good enough.
Wow. So brushing twice and flossing as many times as you want. Abhishek is asking, will you keep doing these online checkups post the lockdown?
Yes, in fact, that's going to be a way of life. That's an interesting question, and I'm glad he asked it. So in our clinic, because we want to reduce the amount of people going up and down from the clinic, since there's going to be social distancing for a long time, we're going to be doing a lot of online dental consultations. If we can help them online, they do not need to come into the clinic. So there are times when we can just solve them online, and we would continue doing it. So we're going to be doing that in between patients when we are actually getting ready with our other protocols. So I will be available online in my practice hours the whole time.
Lovely. Tanvesh is asking, due to decay, he's got a hole in his tooth. So what should he do for that?
So at the moment, you really can't stick in anything to close that hole, unfortunately. So you will need to see a dentist. As I said, just keep it clean. Make sure no food is collecting there. That's the only thing you can do right now. So do salt water rinses and keep cleaning it up so that there's no food collecting. And as soon as you can get to a dental clinic, get it done, please get the filling done ASAP.
Okay. And how often should we use Listerine in a day? Pooja is asking.
Yes, so Listerine, that's a good point too. I do not promote Listerine to use every day because it does have some alcohol content and it tends to dry up your mouth. So it's really strong, and use it for like 2 weeks or so, because people who have bad breath and want to use it and feel fresh for temporary basis is good. Daily use, Colgate Plax is something that I always advise. It's mild, it's a very good for everyday use, and it's fantastic.
All right. Our time is up though. A lot of questions are coming and a lot of people have said thank you to you. Very informative session. Thanks a lot. And audience, if you mention that you want a session 2 series with Dr. Tarveen Kaur, if you have more questions that have not been answered, we will request her to come back with us. So put those questions down. Whatever she has told, we're going to make a creative of the information, and it goes in a WhatsApp group. So please do join our WhatsApp group with all the information. The link is being just sent to you. So please make sure to become a part. We give a lot of tips about immunity. How do you boost them? We do a lot of fitness challenges, and all the information given by Doc will also be available there. Thank you.
You know,
I can't thank you enough.
I know before you go up, Aarti, I want to thank you for what you're doing, Folk Fitness, and Aarti, you guys are doing fabulous job. And believe me, passing positivity and happiness right now here is the best you can do for everybody. But thank you so much for having me here.
Tarveen, a lot of people are asking for another session with you. I'm sorry, Tanvesh, the time's up. So all these, okay, I'm going to take two more questions for you. One is, Tanvesh has said, thank you, I will make sure to clean my tooth. So that.
Okay.
Poonam is saying, sorry, our last question. Poonam, only for you, I'm going to take the question, but I can't see your question. So please type it quickly. What is your question? Okay, Poonam is asking, what about the charcoal toothpaste?
Okay. So like I said, all toothpaste are the same. The charcoal toothpaste is something new that they've come up with. So, the toothpaste companies have to come up and keep reinventing their toothpaste, because people tend to get bored and they're looking for something new. So your charcoal thing is another advertising thing. I'm not going to say it's way over better than the normal Colgate Total. No, if you like it, it's personal preference. Please go ahead and use it. It's just something new for you to use.
Okay. So just for an experience and a difference, they can use it is.
Yes.
Okay. Hope that answers your question, Poonam. And for the rest of the guys, yes, there are a lot of questions left. We shall answer those. I want to see how many of you want Dr. Tarveen back. And if we see a lot of you requesting for it, I promise you, I speak on behalf of her that she will come back to fitness, because I know she's also doing a great job by consulting online. And if you have any specific problem and you want to reach out to her, it's New Dental Age. You can go to
New Age Dental.
New Age Dental. I'm so sorry.
New Age Dental.
Okay. I'm going to write that down here. New Age Dental.in. If you have any specific questions, you can go there and speak to her, and we will get her back. Repeat session, please. Very informative. Would love to attend another one. Dr. Venu, please come back. Shikha says, it was an amazing session. Folk Fitness, love everything about you guys. Great going. Thanks for all the efforts. Wow, that's amazing. Dr. R. Reena says, too good. So I will also say that to you.
Thank you.
Too good.
Thank
you.
Thank you for treating
me also. Yes, she's my dentist as well. I like to say that. So on that note, thank you, Darveen.
Thank you.
I shall.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye, guys.
Thank you. Enjoy the session. Thank you. Bye.